was the general manager at a safari lodge. And Celine's show, the first New Day show, was shown on TV, and it was my dad's birthday. So we watched it all together, and the first song started. And there's this woman on stage with short blonde hair, and I said to my parents, when's Celine coming out?
Celine and Franco thought about Celine having a new look. So, you know, I was listening and I thought it was a great idea until I learned that the new look they were talking about was cutting her hair short and dye it blonde.
At first, it was a technical situation. The stage pushed my hair forward, and I always had to play with my hair to get it out of my face, and people could not see my face well. So it was probably the most expensive hair color and haircut in the whole industry.
I said, okay, if you want to do that, sure, go ahead, do it.
Well, I decided to go back to my original kind of like long brown hair, because well, people hated it, actually.
Well, they've been following her for 15, 20 years, and it was a bit of a shock to them. And so eventually we had to, you know, revert back to what everyone loves to see her. And, you know, she looked good in the short blonde hair, you know. But it wasn't, the fans weren't ready for it.
Lost people that we loved. Some gave birth to some children. Some left the stage because it was too hard for them physically. Some had personal problems, left for 8 months, came back to finish the journey with us. There was more than shows, it was more than songs and music and dance. It was a 5-year journey. And it's a lifetime. Even though it was tough to start with, I have to say, I'll miss it.
We have to promise each other that we have to start the tour in South Africa, so like this we're going to be sure we can see that wonderful place.
Yeah.
And here we are.
For us as South Africans to welcome Celine Dion to South Africa as she kicks off her Taking Chances tour.
To get to you, I was dreaming while I drove a long street road ahead. Yeah. Could taste your sweet kisses, your arms open wide. The
But I think I know Leka, I know Hesh, with the gesture, I think, Hesh. Which one do I know? Donkey. Oh, I have to put an eye.
Shop. In the camera.
I like that.
In the camera. Do it for
which
us.
Which camera?
This one? That camera.
Let's in three.
See. Shop. Trouble to get to you. Is that all?
Is that all right? This man has the soul of a child, and he has the heart of a mother, and he has the strength of a man.
The taste you sweet kisses, your arms open wide, this fever for you wants to spend in me up.
This is where Mr. Mandela was kept. Okay, all locked up. This is what you will hear. And then they will close the door. And they never, never close the door. Always with a bang. And that's how it goes.
Is that
alright? We were driving in the car and Curtis heard on the radio that Celine was coming to South Africa. So we had a whole year to start planning for the show and to possibly get a meet and greet with her. The 16th of February was our first show, and we made a huge big banner that we took along with us. We were going to be sitting half the way back at the show, and then Jared, Celine's photographer, came up to us and he told us that there were two seats open in the front.
The first Celine show we went to, we of course sat in the front row. And just before the show started, we could see Celine had a tent on the side that she changed in, and I saw that she was looking out at the audience. She was opening the tent, looking out. So I waved at her, and she waved back at me like this, and quickly went back inside. Then a few minutes later, the show started, and she came out, and the first thing she could see was our banner that we had, and every time she was singing she kept looking at it because you couldn't listen. And at the end of Because You Love Me, she was singing and she said, I love you too.
Love is a Pretoria, and you know what, we are at the Celine Dion concert. I'm so excited. I came up here, I've just met up with Curtis Lana, and he hasn't seen it. To me, he seems like the biggest Celine Dion fan. What made you think to make up such a lovely banner?
Well, actually I made the banner because, you see, I'm a really big fan. I'd love to meet her.
Sing I Drove All Night.
Drove all night to get to you.
Boom, 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 boom.
Is that all right?
There you go. That wasn't so bad.
How do I get you on love?
And I don't know much about your world, but don't wanna be alone tonight on this planet they call.
We just had a huge thunderstorm with hail, and it was raining, and then Celine came out for the sound check. So I was standing right in the front of the stage for the sound check, and there was nobody there. And I had my letter with me that I wanted to give to Celine, and I'd given this letter to just about everybody, and I stood there and I showed the letter to Celine, and Michelle said, you know, Celine's got your letter, don't worry. And that wasn't good enough for me. I had to put the letter in Celine's hand. So as soon as the sound check ended, Celine went off stage, and I ran around the back and I went through the security guards, and I came running up to her and said, Celine! And she turned around, she got such a fright, and the bodyguards tried to tackle me, and she says, no, leave him. And I came out and I said, Celine, I've got this letter for you, and I started crying, and she took me, and she grabbed me, and she said, don't cry, and she held me, and then she started crying, and then I said, Celine, this letter's for you, and she took it, and she said, oh, thank you, I'm going to go read this now. And then I said, Celine, can I get a picture with you? Yeah, and she called Jared, took a picture, and then I said, no, can I get one with my camera? And she goes, oh, okay. So I took out my camera, and she said, Michelle, you just press this button, take the picture. So he took the camera, and he took the picture, and then gave me the camera, and she said, check the picture. So I checked it, and I said, Celine, Michelle made a video. And she went, oh, Michelle, you're so stupid. So she took the camera, and she adjusted, and she said, Michelle, take another one.
And I don't know much about your world.
You are a big inspiration for the rest of the world. You're I know you're going through a lot, and but your spirit and your energy is beyond expectation, and I want to thank you very much for what you are giving. Your strength and your energy is just amazing. We learned so much from you for being here, and I want to thank you for welcoming us in your amazing country, and you be safe.
Patrick said we should give him our banner before the second show, and then later that afternoon we spoke to Renee.
And Carlo comes up to me and he says, okay, Renee is going to come speak to you in a few minutes. So I thought, okay. And then a few minutes later, Renee came up and he said, I believe you have something that you want Celine to sign. So I said, yes, the photo of me and her yesterday. And he looked and then he said, okay, she's coming down now. And I said, can I get a picture with you? And he said, yes, Celine is coming now. And I said, no, with you. And he said, oh, okay. And we took a picture, and then he phoned Celine, and we could see Celine in her room. And he said, that young boy who gave you a fright yesterday is here again.
While I was waiting, Sylvie gave me a phone call and said that Celine had read the letter that Curtis had given her. And that Celine wanted to see us later that evening.
And Celine came down the lift, and she came out with the camera crew and everybody. And she came out, oh, hi, how are you, you know? And then I gave her the picture to sign, and she was signing, and she looked at me, and she said, we're going to get a much better picture now. And then she said to my mom, would you like to get a picture? So we took a picture, and then she said, okay, I will see you guys tonight. That night, we saw Celine again, and it was quite emotional for my mom. And I had some roses that I gave to Celine.
I was so overwhelmed. I couldn't even see straight. There was tears in my eyes. I was looking all over the place. There was cameras everywhere. Didn't know where to look. Celine was standing there looking so beautiful and gorgeous, just like a Barbie doll. And I looked terrible. And then Celine presented me with our banner, which Patrick had had her autograph for us. And again, I was totally blown away. With Renee and Celine and Patrick, and then of course Celine was trying for the babies, and then in October when everything happened, I sent Celine and Renee a beautiful message about the babies and Nelson and Eddy and everything that it meant to her.
My mom gave me a call early that morning and said she got an email from Patrick and that we will be seeing Celine again.
Obviously she was quite taken by the email.
And you should always know, wherever you may go, no matter where you are, I never will be far away.
So anxious to get to Vegas, and then flying, and we go through the clouds, and out of nowhere all these lights appear and it's Vegas. And
we stayed with our good friends Alexandra and Jerry Rittmiller, we call her Alex. They took us into every single show into Vegas and back to their house, which was quite far in Summerlin. Alex would say, hey Jer, we're going to Las Vegas.
Jerry and Alex take us to the Coliseum to go collect our tickets for the Celine show, and on the way there we run into Elise.
You know, out of there, somewhere there where Celine is?
No, she kept her house, we didn't.
No.
We sold it because we went back home, Montreal, we're missing Montreal.
But you're married with Dennis.
Dennis, exactly.
That's right.
See here.
Let's get a photo. Okay, let me just get you two first.
I was shorter than you last time.
Remember, you were shorter than you last time.
Because I had the...
I just put my glasses on. I'm so sorry.
Maybe the last time I had heels too, no?
Let's try that one again.
The first show was the 15th of April, which was my birthday, so it was very special to me. Finally, we get into the Coliseum auditorium for the first show. I cannot explain to you how excited I was.
Inside, we run into Patrick and Joe, and he recognizes me like that, and it was just amazing. Dennis Savage and Eve Ukwan, who I had met before in South Africa, so it was nice to see them again, and they remembered me. And also Eve showed me his office with all the patterns and everything for the lighting effects and everything, so it was great to see that.
Me as a lighting designer, I was like, if you put the big white wall and I have dancers going and the cross lights and everything, it's going to be a nightmare for me. So I was really pushing for another type of technology. I had another discussion with one of the accountants of the company, and he was giving me shit. You're crazy to make Renee and Celine spend that amount of money, and how you nuts? And he said at the end of the phone, he said, but you know what? I just talked to Renee, and he wants it. So I was like, oh, I have Renee on my side. So when I received a yes, we were able to say that, okay, on a new day, Celine Dion will have the biggest indoor screen in the world.
One of the challenges we had when we put the sound system together was the fact that the theater is round. When you're a sound person, a round building is really not a fun thing to work with. You have many reflections all coming back to the center where Celine is standing.
There were so many parts of the show that I absolutely love. I think my favorite part of the show would be the James Bond segment. After the first show, we met up with Kathy Potter and her husband Don. It was really nice to see them. Ramona Almirez. I don't think there is a bigger Celine fan, and her friend, of course, Christine Despin. Those two are, they inseparable. Before the meet and greet on the 17th of April, which was Celine's last show before she took a break and went back to Florida, we were with Patrick, and I gave him a vuvuzela. He said, oh, vuvuzela, you know. And he tried to blow it, and he didn't know how to blow it. So he gave it to me. And of course, you know how loud a vuvuzela is. So I blew it, and it was backstage. And the echoing went everywhere. And all the crew and the band, they all came out of the offices looking what was going on.
Everybody knows Celine loves shoes. So we decided we want to bring her something pretty unique from South Africa. And this was perfect. So we had some custom-made Zulu sandals made for her.
At the meet and greet now, Celine walks into the room.
And she was so tall. And I actually went, I tried to actually take her dress and lift it to see what she was wearing under there, because I couldn't believe that Celine was still so tall.
And she comes in, hi guys, how are you, you know? And then she said, welcome to America. And then we gave her the vuvuzela. And she looked at it, she was a little bit confused. And I said, you know what this is? And she said, no. I said, you know, during the Soccer World Cup, this is a vuvuzela. And she goes, oh, I said, yes, this is the noise that you would hear during the games. And she went, oh my God. She said, Renee Charles is going to freak out.
We gave Celine a big packet of gifts, many, many gifts from South Africa, which I'm sure you don't mind if we don't share that with you.
And then Celine says to me, oh, you got so tall. You know, from last time when she saw me until now. And then I gave her the Zulu sandals, and she looks at them, she said, are these for me? And I said, yes. And she loved them. She said, oh, they're so cute. And she was showing them to everybody in the room, and to Patrick, and to Anna. and everybody who was there.
That was our third show, and it was quite sad because, you know, I figured that's going to be the last time we're going to see Celine. We spent the rest of our time with Jerry and Alex, going around Vegas, Hoover Dam, and Lake Mead. Went out to Henderson, and then we actually went to the Grand Canyon, and then we flew to Florida, and then back to South Africa.
Give our bags to the bellboy, and he says, you know, run to the show, they knew we were going to be there. running. We get to the Coliseum, we go in, they didn't even want to check us or anything, they just took our cameras away from us, put the cameras there, so then mom, of course, you know, has to go to the bathroom. So we're waiting in the backstage, and of course Celine comes round the back, and she comes into the auditorium and shakes everybody's hand during a certain song, and I see Celine coming towards me. She's holding her dress up to here, up to her knees, and she's running, you just see these legs coming out, and her bodyguard's with her, and she stops, and she stands by the door, and I'm standing right there, and I go, "Hi Celine," and she looks at me, and she recognizes me, and she goes, "Oh, hi!" If we can try every day to with any luck, then I suppose the music never ends.
It was nice singing with you tonight. And come back tomorrow. I'm here every night.
So after the first Celine show, we went out for dinner with Ramona and Lindsay and Christine and Edwin and Corey and Kristen and Christian and Tammy. So Ramona says, "Okay, anybody want a chip?"
Christian, who'd come all the way from Chicago to meet us with Tammy, and he had actually just met Celine 2 days before, so he was super excited and showed us his pictures. Up later with Christian and Tammy, and we'd all decided to go to the Bellagio and have a look around inside, and then go to the fountains and see the show.
Some cupcake wrappers that you put around the cupcake, had them made, and then got on this side, it's got a nice little card with a little message on the picture. So we got her a few of those, and then we got her some Zulu brew coffee, and then also a nice top from Africa. Some African shortbread, and also some Amarula chocolates. Coffee beans for Celine. For lots of my friends here, I've got this little pendant that I made. It's a little witch on a broom. It's a good luck symbol. So they'll all love to have one because Celine has one. And then we've got this for my friend Adriana. So for Celine, we got her a few gifts as well. Got many of them here. It's got a nice card on it. And then, you know, it's got a little message from us, and then at the top here it says what the cupcakes are, and then this is the wrapper, the little giraffe, which is made by Celine on it. Red one. So I'm not going to open it full because it's really big, but this is just so you can see what it looks like.
like animals and a green one and like a creamish colour one. So I'm not going to open this. It's got like mountains with leopards lying all over the place and then little leopard dots all over the back. And then we made a nice big card, so quite big. It's two A4s. And it's got a picture of us just sitting in a nice frame and Celine with the animals. The back, it's just got that. And on the inside, it's really nice. It's got first picture of me and Celine, second, third, and then the last one in April. And it's just got a little message here for us to Celine. And then we're just going to attach this to her gift bag. We also got a nice caftan with a nice necklace. Got a giraffe on it, well, two giraffes. Maybe you want to.
Adriana and her husband came up from Mexico just to see us. It was so nice to see her. She's such a sweetie.
She gave us so many gifts. She gave me all my gifts in a Harry Potter bag, and of course she knows I love Harry Potter. And she gave me a little piñata from Mexico.
Yeah. Something went wrong.
On the way to the Forum Shops, we run into Michel Dion, which is Celine's brother. He's also her stage manager. And so we started chatting, and he remembered me, which was nice. And I showed him a picture of me and him when I was here at Monte Cassino in 2008. And he looks at the phone and goes, and he points at himself. He goes, this guy, he hasn't changed. And he points at me. He says, this guy's a different person.
During Seduces Me, Celine's sitting in a large chair, and we have only male dancers coming in. I came, I tried to follow all those dancers, was the one just before the last one. It was, you know, like the other guys, but I would try to keep my belly in. It was like, you know, like dancer, because dancers have shape like, not like mine, you know. So I was walking on stage, and when I just go through, you know, Celine's, I was walking up from the chair, she was in, thinking about what the song was, and didn't see me yet. And then when she opened her eyes, I was just up front of her, and I let my belly go, like, you know. She was 10 seconds after I had to sing. Can you imagine in your head that try to control the laughing and everything? That was amazing.
Everything you are, everything you be. Which is the current of love.
This guy comes up to me and he says to me on the quiet, he says, do you want some tickets? $500, you know.
So mom comes up to me with this guy, and I look at him and he looks really shady. So she says, this guy's got better tickets, you know, we want to see the show up close. And I look at him, I say, no, this guy's not right. So after Ramona and all of them said it's okay, I said to the guy, you know, we're sitting with those people, we're not. We're sitting with those people, and they're not happy that we're buying better tickets than them. And then he said, okay, I'll sell you these tickets for $150 each.
So now I come to you with open arms, nothing to hide. Believe what I say. So here I am with open arms, hoping you'll see what you love. Thank you so much.
When I was a little girl.
Love can move up. She runs off the stage. She's right on the side there, on the right hand side where we are, and there she goes for attention. She runs off. She comes back on when the song starts, and she's right there standing there. So I jump up and I wave at her. And she looks at me, and she shrugs her shoulders, and she pulls her face, you know. So all the people who were sitting in the front that we knew, they all turned around, and Celine comes running up to my side. So I'm standing up and I'm jumping and I'm dancing, you know, and I'm in the aisle with her, so she can see me directly, and I can see her. She's like from here to the wall, and she's dancing and she's pointing her baton at me, you know, singing. She stood there for about half of the song, just dancing in the aisle. And then she went to the one side and she came straight back to me.
After the show, we went to dinner at Max Brenner with Janita.
She used to be Celine's dancer in A New Day. She was the girl in the wedding dress. She would, you know, run backstage, change her wedding dress, and then come out, and she'd get pulled across the stage in midair, you know, in this wedding dress for My Heart Will Go On.
Well, I'm gonna be a streetful as my puppet. No, I'll never let you down. Cause it was stronger, a career of flowers. And it can make me wrong. And heaven knows. And it can sweet me wrong. As it grows to you.
South Africa, I met her and, you know, became friends with her. And the last time we were in Vegas in April, she came up to me after the one show and said, "Oh, hi Curtis, you know, I heard you were gonna be here." I didn't believe it. So we met then again, and this time she invited us out for dinner. So we went for dinner at Max Brenner, and she's now Celine's choreographer and assistant stage manager.
Just like Tina loves to sing.
Jerry and Alex, our good friends from Las Vegas, met up with us.
Baby, baby, baby.
Just had a shower and I am now getting ready to go see Celine and meet her.
Yay!
We're dressed, we've got the gifts ready, and we're off to the show to go meet Celine. But before the show, we had to go see everybody at the Munch Bar.
Unfortunately, we were not able to actually eat with them as we were meeting Celine that night, but we did promise to stop by and just say hi.
They had a big Celine fan gathering. So we went there and it was so nice. We took pictures and Adriana made a banner and she wanted everybody to sign it. Anna, she comes and collects us for the meet and greet.
I've seen the tears and the heartache, and I felt the pain.
She says this in front of, you know, the whole group that she's going to take back to stage to meet Celine. She says, okay, I've got Curtis here, we're coming now.
Patrick and Joel says to the cameraman, these are my two friends from South Africa, and I would like to get a photograph of them. So anyway, we're standing there, and Patrick stands on Celine's little spot, you know, where they take the photos. And we're all bunched up together there, and he says, he'll be Celine. And so we're all holding together, and I looked at him and I said, oh, you're so gorgeous, you know. Oh,
all so of the promises broken, and all of the songs left unsung, seem so far away as I make my way.
And Lisa says, oh, here's the banner that Celine signed for you in front of the whole group. And everybody's like, huh?
To believe in, you gave me love. To believe in, and feeling the same.
And Celine goes, oh, hi. And Patrick says, you know, they want a competition to come back. And Celine goes, wow, you know, that's amazing. And then I gave her the caftan with the giraffe on it. And she looked at it and she was just going, oh, she couldn't believe that we bought her this, you know. And she just loved it. She kept touching it and looking at it. So she was showing everybody, and then she started handing it to Anna. And she looked at me and she said, what do you want to... She said, Anna, can you please fold this up nicely? And she said, then she looked at me and she said, or do you want to get a picture with the caftan? So I took a picture with the caftan. And then I said, look at my shoes. I had to buy these shoes with a base like this. I said, I had to buy these shoes to be taller than you. And Mom showed her shoes. And Celine went, oh my gosh. Then me and Celine took a picture on her own, and we hugged like this.
I cried, if I say. And then Celine put her hand out towards me, and I took her hand and I said to her that I loved her. And she took my hand, she squeezed it, and she said, I love you so much.
You gave me a world to believe in. You gave me a love to believe in. And feeling this love, I can rise up above. Be strong and be whole once again. Cause your love heals my soul once again. I can live, I can dream once again. You made me believe.
For all those times you stood by me, for all the truth that you made me see, for all the joy you brought to my life, for all the wrong you made right, for every dreams you make come true, for all the love I found in you, I'll be forever thankful, baby. You're the one who held me up, never let me fall. You're the one who saw me through.
Janita had surprised us with a backstage tour, and you couldn't take any pictures, it's just not allowed. But they showed us Celine's dresses for the show up close, and Celine has two of every dress, and they are just, the dresses are fantastic. If you see them up close, you can see they've got diamonds all over them, and the Armani Privé dress for the open arms, you can see it has got all the crystals sewn on. When she runs off, she takes the clothes off, and straight away they send the clothes to dry cleaning and clean it. And they came in with the Mahatma Gandhi's, the blue one, and Zorba was there. And she said, you know, look at this dress, it's soaking wet. She said, you can see that's real water around Celine, it's not a light effect. She showed us Celine's dressing room, it's huge. then showed us the dressing room Celine uses, you know, while the show is on, and Celine does the quick changes, and there's actually there's heaters in the room to make it hot, so when Celine goes off and changes, she doesn't get cold and her voice stays fine. And under the stage there is, I thought it would be quite a big tank, but it's not so big, with all the water inside, which comes down around Celine for my heart to go on. And we went on stage, and it was so nice to see the Coliseum from this side instead of from in the audience. And after the backstage tour, Janita had to go because her fiance, who had just come back with all the big bosses from AEG Live, met up with Nikki and Marina and Acacia and all their mothers that came with, and took pictures and chatted. It was really nice. It's like 2 a.m. in the morning. Renee walks up, so we chatted and then we took a picture.
A very emotional moment came when her father passed away on November 30th, 2003. You know, we told her that, of course, she doesn't have to do the show, and she insisted on doing the show that night because she said Dad would want me to do the show.
Tonight is a very special night for me. It is also a very difficult day. I've lost my dad this morning. I insisted of coming. My dad was and still is my number one fan since I'm a very little girl. And and I know that my dad would have wanted me to be here tonight on stage with everyone I love, doing what we love. And we always think that we're so strong, but I know that he is here, and I will tonight perform the very best I can, and I will give everything I have, and I would like to dedicate the show to him.
People were in pain as much as I was. It was awful, but I did it for my dad. I collapsed backstage after the end of the show, and thank God my brother was there.
That night I was not stage manager, but I was Celine's brother, and I'm very proud of it.
I want to thank everybody for participating in my film. I am so honored to have met you all, whether in person or online. I would like to say a special thank you to you, Celine, for bringing all of us together. Without you, I would not have had the opportunity of meeting such wonderful fans, your awesome band, crew, and management. My heartfelt thanks to you, Celine, from my mom Cheryl and myself, for all the most amazing meetings that you have so graciously afforded us with your time and affection. We are truly blessed to have had the pleasure of being with the biggest diva of all time, Celine Dion. Until we meet again, until then, goodbye. Merci beaucoup.